النسك and التلبية. The Hajj rites and statement of ascent. النسك. When the person intending ihram has finished bathing and cleaning himself and has worn his ihram garments and the male has taken off any fitted garments, he then makes the intention to commence النسك, either for Hajj or Umrah. It is recommended to state clearly the sequence of nusuk the person intends to perform. For instance, he says, when he wishes to perform a tamattu', that is, umrah, after which he becomes released and disengaged from the obligations of ihram before starting hajj. Labbayk Allahumma umratan mutamatti'an biha ila al-hajj, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Umrah, after which I will become released from the obligations of Ihram until I start Hajj. Or, Labbayk Allahumma Umrah, the meaning of which is, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Umrah. Then at Hajj, he says, Labbayk Allahumma Hajjan, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and I am ready to serve you through Hajj. And the person who intends Hajj al-Ifrad, which means Hajj alone, he says, Labbayk Allahumma Hajjan, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Hajj. While the person who intends to merge Hajj and Umrah together, known as Qiran, says, Labbayk Allahumma Hajjan wa Umrah, the meaning of which is, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Hajj and Umrah. This is according to the hadith by Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, say, O Allah, I answered your call and here I am to serve you through Hajj and Umrah. However, if one does not pronounce anything, the intention he made in his heart is enough. After entering into the state of Ihram, a Muslim starts to perform al-Nusuk. This refers to the words and actions of the rites of worship performed during Hajj or Umrah. There are many different sequences of al-Nusuk. The first type is al-Tamattu'. This is by assuming Ihram for Umrah in any of the months of Hajj, and thereafter disengaging from Ihram after completing the Umrah. Then later in the same year, assuming Ihram for Hajj. The second type of al-Nusuk is al-Qiran. This is by assuming Ihram for Hajj and Umrah at the same time. And the third type is called Al-Ifrad. This is by assuming Ihram for Hajj alone. The three types differ concerning the Ihram for each. For Al-Tamattu', one assumes Ihram twice. The first Ihram for Umrah, which he then disengages himself from. And then another Ihram for Hajj. But one assumes Ihram once for Hajj and Umrah together when performing Al-Qiran. And similarly, the person assumes Ihram only once for Hajj when performing Al-Ifrad. Concerning Al-Talbiyah, for the first Ihram, one performing Al-Tamattu' says, Labbayka Allahumma Umrah, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Umrah. Then, when starting Hajj, he says, Labbayka Allahumma Hajjan, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and I am ready to serve you through Hajj. Or he can say once at the beginning, Labbayka Allahumma Umratan Mutamatti'an Biha ila al-Hajj, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Umrah, after which I will become released from the obligations of Ihram until I start Hajj. But for the one performing Al-Qiran, he says, Labbayka Allahumma Hajjan wa Umrah, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Hajj and Umrah. And the person who intends Hajj al-Ifrad says, Labbayk Allahumma Hajjan, which means, O Allah, I have answered your call and here I am to serve you through Hajj. A sacrificial animal is compulsory for those who are performing al-Tamattu' and al-Qiran. On the other hand, a sacrifice is not compulsory for one performing Hajj al-Ifrad. Al-Tamattu' consists of two circumambulations, the first for Umrah and the second for Hajj. But For Al-Qiran and Al-Ifrad, there is one compulsory circumambulation, and that is for Hajj. Concerning the Sa'i, which is the stroll between Safa and Marwa, for the Tamattu', there are two compulsory strolls, the first for Umrah and the second for Hajj. On the other hand, for Al-Qiran and Al-Ifrad, there is only one stroll, which is the stroll of Hajj. The best types of Hajj rites is at Tamattu'. This is because the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, ordered his companions to observe it. This is followed by Al-Qiran, then Al-Ifrad. At-Talbiyah. The Muslim says, Labbayka Allahumma labbayk, labbayka la sharika laka labbayk, inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk, la sharika lak. The meaning of which is, I am here at your service, O Allah. I am here at your service. You have no partner. Surely all praise and blessings are yours, and also all sovereignty. You have no partner. Labbaik, Allahumma labbaik, means I wish to respond time after time to your call. The talbiyah is sunnah, or it is a recommended and non-obligatory act. A man raises his voice when saying it, and a female lowers her voice, not to cause any temptation. The Muslim begins to say the talbiyah after assuming ihram, and he repeats it several times on his way to many places and whilst doing various activities. There are many situations when the act of saying talbiyah is more likely to be accepted by Allah. For example, when he ascends a hill or descends into a valley, or observes a prescribed salah, or at nightfall, or as the day brightens. He ceases to say the talbiyah during Umrah, when he sees the house, meaning the Kaaba, and reaches the black stone. Concerning Hajj, he would cease to say the talbiyah at the moment he starts stoning Jamaratul Aqaba on the Eid or festive day.